Chapter 1, Intro.
Welcome, smart home enthusiasts. Ever feel like your smart home is getting smarter while you're just standing there, still figuring out how to program your microwave clock? Yeah, same. But don't worry. That's why I'm here. I get asked all the time, where do you buy your smart home gadgets? So from now on, I'll be including that info, plus the price, in every video. Because let's be honest, we all love a good deal. Today, we're checking out the Sonoff ZBMicro, a tiny but mighty ZigBee USB switch. I picked this one up from AliExpress for just £8.81. But is it actually a steal, or just another great deal that ends up in the junk drawer? Let's find out. Quick disclaimer. This video is not sponsored by AliExpress, nor by Sonoff. My channel is still way too small for sponsors. Sadly, no free gadgets for me. Every device you see is paid for out of my own pocket. And all reviews are 100% honest and unbiased. Because if something is junk, you deserve to know. Enough chit-chat. Let's get back to business. What's in the box? Not much. But hey, sometimes less is more. Sonoff ZBMicro. Small but could be mighty. Quick start guide. For those rare folks who actually read them. No extras. No unnecessary fluff. Just the essentials.
Chapter 2, Installation.
Let's get this ZigBee USB switch working in Home Assistant. Installing this thing is so simple that even your dog could do it. If only it had thumbs. Step 1, pair the switch. First, put your ZigBee gateway into pairing mode. If you're using ZigBee 2 MQTT, click Permit Join in the web interface. Now, grab your ZBMicro and plug it into a USB port. It should enter pairing mode automatically. If it doesn't, just press and hold the pairing button until it starts blinking like it's sending Morse code. Hurry up, Home Assistant. Give it a moment. Home Assistant will detect it soon. Once it pops up in your device list, congratulations. You're officially smarter than your smart switch. Step 2, give it a name. Click the Rename Device button in your ZigBee 2 MQTT interface and give your new shiny gadget a proper name. Don't just go with something dull like USB switch 1. That's just lazy. Instead, pick a name that actually makes sense while keeping it simple. For example, I named mine SW USB Entrance Rocks. SW, a shortcut for switch because efficiency matters. USB, pretty obvious, right? Entrance, because that's where it's installed. Rocks, because it controls USB lights that illuminate part of my mineral collection. Yes, and that kind of nerd. Before clicking Rename Device, make sure to enable Update Home Assistant Entity ID to keep everything neat and organized. Need help naming your devices? Check out my video, The Perfect Naming Conventions. Simplify your smart home. Click the pop-up in the top right or find the link in the description. Step 3, make it feel at home. Your smart home setup deserves to be as organized as your kitchen spice rack, or at least slightly better than that chaotic junk drawer. Go to Settings in the left menu. Click Devices and Services, then switch to the Devices tab. Find your new switch and click on it. Tap the pencil icon to edit. Assign it to a room. Living room? Office? Secret lair? No judgment, but now I kinda want a secret lair too. Add labels if you want to be extra organized. Click Update. Boom! You're done! And that's it! Your new ZigBee USB switch is paired, named, and fully set up like a pro. Now let's put this budget-friendly gadget to the test and see if it's a smart home hero or just another overhyped piece of plastic.
Chapter 3, Testing.
Moment of truth. Time to see if this little gadget is actually useful. Plug in a USB device, anything will do. A fan, a lamp, a highly questionable USB coffee warmer, or maybe even a tiny disco ball, you name it. Now press the power button on the ZBMicro. Did it turn on? It should. If not, either you've got a defective unit or technology is just messing with you again. Wouldn't be the first time. Now let's control it from Home Assistant. Go back to your device and click the toggle button. Did it work? Congratulations. You now have the power to turn things on and off without even leaving your chair. True Smart Home Royalty. If it's all working, fantastic. If not, don't panic. Troubleshooting is just part of the smart home journey. And honestly, sometimes the universe just enjoys keeping us humble.
Chapter 4, Automation.
Now that we've confirmed this little gadget isn't just a glorified USB stick, it's time to make it actually do something, automation. As I mentioned earlier, I use this USB switch to illuminate a few of my mineral specimens because, let's be honest, glowing rocks just look cool. Here's how it works. I plug the USB hub into the switch, connected 6 USB lamps to the hub, and place my minerals on top of the lamps because, well, science and aesthetics. I also added a switch to my dashboard so I can easily control my lights. Then I created two automations for my rocks. At 11 p.m., the lights turn on, giving my minerals that museum-quality glow. After sunrise, the lights turn off, because even rocks need a break, and honestly, the glow just doesn't have the same effect during the day. No fancy AI. No complicated scripts. Just a simple, hands-off way to make my minerals look amazing without me having to lift a finger.
Chapter 5. Final thoughts.
Overall, in my completely unbiased, 100% honest, cross-my-heart opinion, the Sonoff ZBMicro is a wallet-friendly, compact, and ridiculously simple, yet surprisingly effective addition to any home assistant setup. The response time? Faster than finding the TV remote when it's missing. You can toggle it manually, and it works with Home Assistant right out of the box. No headaches, no drama. It's perfect for controlling LED strips, USB hubs, or any other USB-powered gadget you're too lazy to unplug yourself. I've had a few of these in my setup for over 6 months now, and so far, not a single issue. This little ZigBee warrior just keeps going, doing its job without a fuss, unlike some overpriced smart home gear we won't name. For the price, the Sonoff ZBMicro is an absolute steal. A must-have for any smart home enthusiast. Highly recommend it, and no doubt about it.
I can't believe this could be.
Chapter 6. Thank you.
Thanks for sticking around until the end. If you found this review helpful, give that thumbs up button a tap. Gently, no need to break your mouse. Subscribe and let me know in the comments how you'd use this little gadget. Want to support the channel? Buy me a coffee because caffeine equals more smart home shenanigans. Or check out my Patreon. Links are in the description. See you in the next one. Stay powered and happy switching!